All right, so you spoke recently in Parliament about some enhancements to the Workfare Income Supplement Scheme. Then there's a bit of banter online that, you know, it doesn't matter how much you give people, it's just not going to be enough. So how would you respond to this?
So to help our low-income workers, in 2007, we introduced the Workfare Income Supplement, or Workfare as we know it, to help them with their household expenses and certainly their cost of living concerns. Beyond salary support, the government also provides multi-layered support. So let me show you how this works. You're going to see that on top of Workfare, there are also other supports that we provide, such as GST vouchers, USAF rebates. So really, if you look at the levels of support that we have, it does address the different cost of living concerns in a household, whether it's household expenditure or healthcare or education costs. And this is how we provide support for all our low-income families holistically.
So since we're talking about support and about Workfare, there has been some traction on this point that why don't we just introduce a minimum wage in Singapore instead of having to deal with Workfare?
So unlike minimum wage, it is that the cost of Workfare is not passed on to employers or consumers. What we have achieved here in Singapore is higher employment, low unemployment, as well as better salaries for low-income workers. I think that says quite a lot.
So retirement is also something that those in the lower income would be thinking about. Is there anything that is in the works to help them?
We also invest in the human capital by providing Workfare Training Support as well as skills future credits to help them certainly upgrade themselves, be more productive. So I think that's also part of the spirit of Workfare.
And thank you very much, MOS, for taking the time to share with us a little bit more about how it is that we're helping the lower income workers.
Thank you.